Well, the Quincy Climate Action Network has a special presentation at the library this month all about climate change. Is it getting hot in here? That's kind of the topic. It is coming up Tuesday, January 13th from 7 to 8:30 p.m. And Rebecca McWilliams of QCAN has stopped by to tell us a little bit about it and about QCAN. So, Rebecca, good to talk to you.
Thank you so much,
Happy
Joe.
New Year.
Happy New Year to you,
Thank
2015.
You very much. Yeah, exactly.
Just a little bit about Quincy Climate Action
Please,
Network.
Yeah.
We are entering our third year of active involvement in the Quincy community. Our goal is to educate residents and homeowners and renters alike about what they can do in their own homes to reduce their climate change by reducing energy use and saving some money. And our topics range from weatherizing and winterizing your home to installing renewable energy. And we're pushing this year for solar. Mm-hmm. So check out our website, qcan.org, to learn more about what's happening this spring.
Great. So talk to us about this presentation. You've brought an expert in the field of climatology to the library.
That's right, yeah. Dr. Stephen Young. And he actually is a lecturer in the geography department at Salem State University.
Okay.
We're very excited to have him because he's a local Northeast expert on topics related to the environment and climate. So this is really exciting to have someone who understands our specific needs and is a Massachusetts professor. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So he's very involved and interested in this sort of information.
Okay. And what will be kind of the crux of his presentation? What's he talking about?
Sure. So the big question is this hot in here that we are experiencing, is it weather or is it climate change?
Yeah.
And so the question is, when you talk to someone and they say, oh, well, you know, it's freezing cold and it's snowing, so much for climate change, so much for global warming.
Right.
Well, what they're saying is the weather is cold. But that doesn't necessarily mean that the climate is still the same that it has been for the last 10, 20, 50 years.
Mm.
And so he's really sort of splicing hairs to get to, it's about climate change. It's about global averages and regional averages. It's not about, today it's really cold and it's snowing.
Okay, so it's trends, basically, and
right.
more longer term effects as opposed to, like say, what's doing this afternoon outside?
Right,
yeah.
So you may hear people saying, well, I don't see any difference,
mm-hmm.
or perhaps they see a little bit of a difference, but it's hard to actually put your finger on climate change unless you're a scientist.
Right.
And so that's the exciting part about bringing in an expert who really does have a focus on these issues mm-hmm. and has a PhD in understanding what's happening and is able to share that in layman's terms to people who may not otherwise understand
mm-hmm.
what's the difference, what's happening, and what can I do?
Yeah. What's kind of QCAN's position, Rebecca, on climate change and global warming? You know, where do you stand on that?
Obviously, we're a climate action network,
right.
and so part of our mandate is to make a difference and try to mitigate the effects of climate change. One of the words that we hear a lot of people talking about is the word belief or believe,
mm-hmm.
and we try to stay far away from that word because this is not about a religious understanding. This is not about where you stand on the issue or what your background is. This is about scientific facts. And what are the trends, and what can we do as residents of Quincy to mitigate things like sea level rise? Obviously, we're a coastal community,
yeah.
so we want to make sure that people are not emitting greenhouse gases unless they absolutely need to. They're not burning fossil fuels unless there really is no other choice. So part of this is education, and part of this is just explaining to people that this is happening.
Right.
This is not a belief thing. This is really happening,
yeah.
and what can you do?
Okay.
You know, don't get overwhelmed.
And I understand Dr. Young will actually bring some evidentiary proof
yes.
that there is climate change based on studies that have been done.
Right.
Yeah.
He certainly has the local data for the Northeast region.
Right. Will he take questions from folks?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay.
One of the exciting things about Dr. Young's lecture, one of our QCAN members attended a previous lecture in the fall of 2014. So one of the exciting things about his lecture is that he's really engaging and he's able to answer very specific tailored questions.
Okay.
That's the best part is the discussion.
Yeah.
So there certainly will be a discussion forum for people to ask specific questions.
It's, you know, certainly of concern here right in Quincy. Folks who live along the coast have been impacted with the new federal flood insurance
maps,
zones
yeah.
that are causing such controversy. And the study that was done with the planning department, the sea level rise study that shows the dramatic
mm-hmm.
impacts that could happen. So
right.
people could have you know, street-specific questions for him, basically.
They could.
Yeah.
And I think that it's important to look at sort of the regional response.
Mm-hmm.
I know that Boston has been working on a climate response plan.
Right.
And they've offered to include Quincy in that.
Yep.
I think that it's very valuable for us to get involved, to share information, and to have a strategy to handle, let's say, the next superstorm that comes to this region.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, we look forward to the presentation. Sounds fascinating.
Thank you so much, Joe.
Thank you. Appreciate you coming by. And again, the presentation, it's getting hot in here. Is it just the weather, or is it really the climate changing? It's Tuesday, January 13th, 7 to 8:30 p.m. It's in the Maine Library's community meeting room, the one on the ground floor. And you can learn more about this and all of the programs at the library through their website, which is thomascranelibrary.org.